today we're here with the chef, Nick, and we're going to be talking about your life story. So, go ahead.
Yeah, I'm just a little boy who's born in a valley, a small town in Thailand called Mae Hong Son. It's about 360 kilometers from Chiang Mai, the second big city of Thailand. So I born there, and then I educated that in my hometown until for 15 years, for a year. And then when I'm young, and then I want to find out myself what I want to do in my life. Very young age, and then I find out myself when I'm 12. I say I want to speak different language, that people can talk different languages in the world. And then I couldn't click it out. I failed English. I failed the English. But I want to speak English, but I couldn't figure it out how I can speak good English. So I want to be the top person in the world. Everything what I do, I try to put a foundation and basic, and I practice to do the best of it. And then one day I went to play gymnastics, then I like it. And I realized that one is a foundation of sport. Then after that, in a school I've been bullied. I went to Thai boxing school for learning how to protect myself. But after 3 months, they put me on the ring. Then I knocked out my opponent in the first 30 seconds. Then after I keep going fighting, and then I make money. The first fight I got 60 baht, must be about £1.20. And I'm so happy with that. But people throw money on the ring, and the more than money I get paid. So I enjoy it. And then after 13, and then I left home.
At 13?
At 13, yeah.
Wow.
I left home because I think I can look after myself, and then I can make money. I want to go to explore the world. So I left at 13, and I fight. I got a manager who's on the Thai boxing. I got the trainer. But I earn money to live in. When I was in Chiang Mai, I study there, and then I eat 1 baht for sticky rice, about 2p, and then 2 baht for the food. So I drink the tap water first for food, and then I eat like that for a whole year. Then I stay in the room, cost about £5 a month.
Wow.
And then I got one uniform only. Then when I go to school, I come back, I wash it, and I forget no iron. I have no iron. Then I just do like that every day for a whole year. Then evening, I went to work and I serve a noodle in noodle soup and some kind of street food things. And then they pay me for having food to leave. That's good. But I've been tailed off from it. I think one day I'm going to be the boss. But I'm going to be a nice boss. I'm not going to be like shit like this. So then I build myself up. Then I fight all around in the north of Thailand. And then I went to my hometown. I went to my hometown to see my mother. And then 2 days, and then I went to see my friend in the King Project. And then I ending this, look after the farm for the King Project. So, and then after that, I've been working there, and then one day I went to the border. I've been training like an army, but I'm not army. So they do jumping show in the King Project. The King come visit that Bang Tong and the palace every year, once a year. So I have to do the jumping show in front of the King. But that year he not come. So we went to the border of Burma, and we come back late at night. We didn't have a pass or the checkpoint. I've been shot with the M16.
Wow.
M16. But I'm not died. But so I fell down from the horse. because of me, my friend is me, and my friend, I think they think I'm a radio person.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what they shot me. So two bullets
yeah.
go through it in the back.
Wow.
So we come down to from the mountain, 29 kilometers by truck to the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And I stayed there for 5 days. I run away for I don't like injection, so I run away, come up to the King Project because they got hospital there as well. So they take care of it. After 2 months, I left the King Project. And my mother said, you should become a monk for lucky.
A monk?
Yeah, a monk. Yeah. So I am become a monk. I said, yeah, okay, for 7 days, for lucky. But I like it. And then I stay for 1 month, and I stay for 3 months. And then one day, and another 1 year, and then 2 years. And one day, and one guy who's a tour guide come to my temple, and he talk English like nobody business.
Mm-hmm.
I said, how can you do that? And then when I thinking, wow, to talk another language, why can't I talk like Thai? So I practice to the speaking and listening. By the way, when you're in school, you learn how to write and read, and grammar, and learn the speaking and reading, and speaking and listening.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the wrong, I thought, that's the wrong way to learn in a school. So this is the correct way, like you English,
mm-hmm.
you born here, and then you speak English already,
mm-hmm.
and then you understand already, and then you go to school to write and read and learn grammar. So I said, why not I do that? So I practice my English. Like I can remember the word from 5 words a night, and 10 words, 20 words, 40 words, 100 words, 1,000
yeah.
words, 2,000 words a night. Practice that. So I sleep 3 hours, and I study Buddhism as well. I study Bali language.
Mm-hmm.
I study Japanese. Use the same technique what I did. 3 months, I got English.
Really?
Yeah. And after that, so I have a national service when I'm 21. That time, 21. So I resigned the monk. So I go to the national service, but I'm not tall enough. I short 1 centimeter. So they go home and say, oh, thank you. And I open a guest house. I open a guest house in my hometown. And then one day, I have a Dutch people, one couple, they say they want to do trekking. I said, what's mean trekking? You walked in the mountain, and then take us to see the hill tribe. Yeah, why not? I can do it. No, we don't want to walk around here. We want to walk from here to Chiang Mai. My God, how do you do that? Walk from here to Chiang Mai, the old days, they walk about like 1 month. Even, it's too long. How you can do that? No, we want to do that. Okay, fine. Then I went to talk with my friend, who's from Hill Tribe Village. I said, how we can get from this village to that? I opened a map. I know how to get in there, but I don't know the way. So I asked my friend, how can I get there to there to there? So he get the guide for me. And then I get paid about 2,400, about 5,000 baht. Just you talk about 100 something, about 140 pounds.
Mm-hmm.
That time a lot of money. 35 years ago,
mm-hmm.
a lot of money. So I paid a guy who taking me to the village. I paid him £2, 100 baht, £2.50. And then from that village, I walk to another village. I pay another guy £2.50 to another village until we get to Chiang Mai. Take about seven days.
Seven days.
Walk in the mountain, sleep in a village.
Wow.
So that's how the trekking come up. So I got a tour company.
Okay.
The tour company. So I started doing trekking for my guest house, and then I set up a tour company called Nick Trekking.
Okay.
So then, I do the trekking all around and my hometown. And great, I walk from Mengso to Chiang Mai, from Mengso to Doi Intanon. That Doi Intanon is high mountain of Thailand. That 14 days, and people love it. To the rafting, the elephant riding.
Sounds fun.
Yeah, that time I have a 4 grand in my pocket. The boy who's 21, 22 years old have a 4 grand in your pocket every day,
Wow, that's good, isn't it?
Yeah, my life is just enjoying that.
And then
I have a Thai restaurant for the tourists. Tanana in Thai. And when the summer, my hometown is so hot. Like, if you go to supermarket, you buy the chicken, and the raw chicken. You go, you get home, that become chicken barbecue. Then how hot is it? The butcher says, money for me as well. So I get home, I get all with my sticky rice and stuff. So
you opened a restaurant on your own?
Yeah.
At 20?
For Kun Thai restaurant.
Kun Thai restaurant?
Yeah, Kun Thai, mean the Thai people.
Mm-hmm.
Then in summer, so hot, so I went to Koh Phangan. I went to Koh Phangan, I bring a Burmese cigar. Burmese cigar and go to Koh Phangan, and then I sell cigar. I bought 100 cigar, cost maybe like two and a half baht. Should be maybe 10p. I sell for 5 baht. I sell on the beach. And then one day, the guy from Switzerland said, "Hey, you're good cooking. Why don't you teaching us cooking?" Okay, cooking school. So I said, "Cooking school in Koh Phangan."
So how old were you at this point?
Then I am 22.
So okay.
22.
So by 22, you've had quite a few businesses.
Yeah. It's crazy. Then I have a different girlfriend. One girlfriend landing, one another girlfriend going up. But I'm not playboy.
You are a playboy.
No,
aren't you?
I play with a girl. I don't play with a boy. So I in Koh Phangan, I do cooking school, and then I
was that in Bangkok?
No, in Koh Phangan.
Oh, okay.
In Koh Samui and yeah. Koh Phangan next to it.
Okay, yeah.
And then I went to Koh Tao, and just one bungalow only for Nang Yuan Bungalow, 1988.
Mm-hmm.
Others said just have water to drink only, no water to take shower at that time. But in Koh Phangan, that time got about like 50 bungalow. Yeah, not many, not like now.
Yeah.
Full moon party.
Yeah, I heard
about full moon party. Yeah, you have to walk 30 minutes to get there. Mm-hmm. But now you've got road everywhere. So when I in Koh Phangan, and then after that I make money, I traveling to Indonesia, Malaysia, Singapore. Yeah, I went to Singapore. They think I Japanese.
They thought you were Japanese?
Yeah, because Japanese. Because I speak Japanese at that time.
Yeah.
Because I met my girlfriend, she don't speak English. So I have to learn Japanese. My God. My goodness. So I come back when I see San for the tourists in my hometown. I come back from the south.
Yeah.
I bought salt egg, I bought dry squid, I bought salt fish, like in North Thailand don't have.
Mm-hmm.
I call my friend in my hometown, what you like, which one you like, and I carry from here to my hometown and I sell them. So I don't need to pay my tailoring, nothing for my tailoring. So that's what I do that every year for 4 or 5 years.
Okay.
Until one day I have my trekking tour in Pai. So my girlfriend from Switzerland.
Another girlfriend?
Yeah, she was Switzerland. she go back to Switzerland for 2 months and left her friend in there. And then she went back to Switzerland for 2 months. Wanna come back to open resort with me.
Alright.
But I got a car accident. This girl who with the friend of my girlfriend with me, and she take care of me for like when I, you know, everyone run away from me because I've been car accident.
Really?
And then the business broke down. That time Saddam Hussein been shooting by America, 1991.
Okay.
Yeah, there was no tourists.
Mm-hmm.
And then my girlfriend Charlie said, "Why not we marry and go to England?" I said, "Oh, a lot of people love me, but people care about me, this girl, it's impossible." So, okay, why not? Then we married in my hometown.
Yeah.
And then after that, a few months, I fly over to England. When I come to England, and then I work in nursing home.
Nursing home?
Yeah, straight away, I work cleaning in nursing home. Mm. I get paid £2.40. And I cry. I said, "Look, I got £4,000 in my pocket, but now £2.40. And then I cried. One cleaner, it has saved my life. She said, "Nick, don't matter where you came from, what you got.
Yes.
You forgot about your past. Think about today and tomorrow, you'll be better." That's it, just click my head. Mm-hmm. I forgot about the past, everything mm-hmm. what I got, money, things up. I just get all my work, things up like that. And everything just come up good. And then I do the menu for the takeaway. I write the menu with a hand.
Which takeaway?
From my house. I keep it in the neighborhood.
Yeah.
And they all help me.
Really? So yeah. You were cooking from home?
Yeah, from home.
Okay.
Yeah, and then I open a Thai restaurant in Worcester. And I teach Thai boxing. I open a Thai restaurant in Worcester. They give me £3,000 to fly back to Thailand to bring all the stuff what we need and come back, you know, in 10 days. I open the restaurant in 10 days. Then after that, and then they got Thai boxing school next to me. Mm-hmm. The guy called Mark Burness. He teaching Thai boxing, got a few people who's in there. I said, yeah, I don't enjoy Thai boxing. And he hold a part for me, kicking like machine gun. And then he take me home, he said, I pay him £2, no? He said, here, you're £2. I can't teach you, you have to teach me that how I get involved in Thai boxing in England.
Okay.
Then he bring me to see Tony Moore, and then Tony Moore, who the chairman of British Thai Boxing Council. So I start fighting in England. Then I start running, nobody can hold part for me. I went to boxing club to do sparring with boxing, normal boxing. So I fight in England about 13 fights and around Europe. So I got 2 British champions. Then I become a British coach for world champion for 2 years, 1996, okay. 97, mm-hmm. to Thailand, bring British team to that. And then I after that, 97, yeah, I divorced. Because we can't go together well, but we never argument. But I want to traveling, I want to work, I want to explore. Yeah. But my wife want to stay where she is. By the way, we meet on her traveling. Mm-hmm. We should like enjoy going traveling together. So okay, we take 3 years to think about that and to make decisions. Then I give a 3-bedroom house, 3 car, and 20 grand money. That's it. I start zero again.
So when you were in England, you were making enough money to buy property?
Yeah. 7 years.
Okay.
Then
that's good.
Mortgage. I work four jobs.
Four jobs?
Up. Yeah. I clean in the morning. I do Thai boxing. I do the work in building side. I work in nursing home. I do cooking.
So you're very hardworking, really.
Yeah. I scared to be poor. I think in nature, no? Yeah. But it's the money, not everything, but good to have them comfortable. But yeah. I always, young age, I scared to be poor, I have nothing to leave to. So, yeah, all done. I start again. Actually, I went to Thailand. I went to Thailand and set up a chiropractic clinic. By the way, I don't have any knowledge. I met an American doctor, chiropractic. And I got diarrhea all the time when I went to Thailand. So she adjusted me when chiropractic is gone. So okay, we do a chiropractic. But I couldn't sleep in Bangkok. I don't use it for the Bangkok. I don't like it. So I went to Pattaya. I see my friend that stayed there 1 month and fly over back to England.
And why didn't you like Bangkok? Too noisy, crowded?
Too noisy, smell.
Yeah.
And you couldn't trust nobody. Like, yeah. You panic all the time. It's not comfortable, to be honest. Then when I fly back to England, I kiss at the ground. So then the next day I got a job straight away, walk restaurant, because okay. I called my friend before I get to England.
Yeah.
So they have walk restaurant one of the chef. So I went there, I got a chef next day I work in. So I work with walk and then I work to with a sales spy, I mean production manager for Corona World Food. And I work around Europe, Korea Hotel, with a consultant. Then I work in Ireland. I set up Fit William. I set up Devon Checker, Singapore Sam, Lemongrass.
These are all restaurants, are they?
Yeah, they're all restaurants and hotels. And I work in Switzerland, Denmark, and Spain. Yeah, I go around a lot.
Yeah.
So I work for Merchant Flatley, private chef. for American flight in Fomoy Castle.
American flight.
No, Michael Flatley.
Oh, Michael Flatley. Okay.
Yeah, Lord of Dance.
Yeah.
That's how the Lord of the Fame came from.
Okay.
Yeah, he's an Irish dancer.
Right.
He was 300 million before.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then he's very good, very good. He keep a lot of idea for me.
Mm-hmm.
He's amazing, this guy. And then so I'm a lot of the plan. I just planning, don't do anything. That's how the Lord of the Plan came from. Yeah. And then match with in Thailand, a guy called Kun Pan in Thailand. Mm-hmm. A lot of the plan. So and then I come back to England. Yeah, I come back to England. No, actually, I met my wife before I went to Thailand. I met my English wife. I met a Thai English wife in Thailand. I met Thai wife in England. My life is a fuckup.com. I tell you, that life is ended. So I then we went to Ireland. Lived there three and a half years, and then working there. And then all my three kids is born in Dublin.
Okay.
So they are Thai Paddy. So
that's
Thai
Paddy.
So they got Irish passport, a Thai passport, a British passport. Then I come back, and then my ex-wife and spend money. I come back with £500,000. Work for 4 years.
Say that again.
I come back with the money for £500,000.
Mm-hmm.
And then she's spending casino £350,000.
In the casino,
yeah,
she
for
spent
2 years. So wow. I buy the ticket for her, one-way ticket, never come back again. This is about 18 years already. Yeah, over 18 years. Because Kevin, that time I was 3.5 months old.
Mm-hmm.
So I become a single father and I look after the kid for 8 years. Then I met my English girlfriend, fiance now. So. And then we have three kids together now.
So how many kids do you have in total?
I have eight.
8 kids,
yeah.
Wow.
One in Thailand, one in Taiwan, one in sick in here in England. I take care of them all.
Good, good.
So then my life is just, you know, called excellent things up. When I was in Worcester the first 4 years, I become British citizen automatically. I pay £5.
Mm-hmm.
£5 for a solicitor for the swear and you know, become
yeah.
British citizen.
Yeah.
But I don't hear he give me the paper here, swear to this. But I don't hear read and I swear to it. I say fuck off. And he said no, not like that. Swear you're reading it. Well, honest to the Queen and country things. Yeah, I said reading that. I thought he said swear to me. Then fuck off. I think in my head, why do you become British citizen? You have to swear to each other. Yeah. That's how I become British citizen by £5. Swear to a citizen. So then now, and then I work in and. And then I come out to work when I met my fiance. This one, I work. And after 8 years, I work in a Thai courtship. I don't tell them who I am, what I am, and then they put me down, like watching out. Things. I want to see how my feeling can go back to work again. Emotion, so much like they put me down. You watching out. Like that, I become patient. And then after 6 months, I said, right, I'm ready to go out to work to do the first things that I went to work with Gustavo Italy. So
okay.
I first go to work shape, and after that I do a production a source for them.
Mm-hmm.
And then one day I went to do a lunch, money lunch for my kid in internet cafe. On that time, we have iPhone things up.
Yeah.
So I top up the money for the lunch for my kid. I say, and I type in Thai chef. He come. He want Thai chef, English. No, Thai, Chinese, Japanese chef for EF language school. Well, and I put my number there. And then he called me in the next 3 hours. And next day I go to see him, and he told to me, he's called David. he did me the 5 kilo chicken and I sauce, I don't know what the sauce, maybe been there for 1,000 years. So I cooking it, for 5 minutes I cooking it and then give to the student to eat. They say, 15 minutes of food gone. He said, come again tomorrow? Yeah, okay. So I come again and after that, I like it. I resign from Busaba.
Yeah.
That work for Yip Language School. And from school, one school, and I become seven branches.
Yeah. Wow.
My boss, he do for one school, 11 years for one branch. Mm. I moved there 2012. I make to now a seven branch.
Mm.
Yeah. And then one day, now the COVID, right? The COVID, I sell my karanga sauce.
Yeah.
I sell my karanga sauce. I'm busy, I sell from home with a friend. I sell 2,600 bottle. And then one day, Tom is introduced me to Kelvin and Jerry. And then he test my sauce. We talk 1 hour. We shake hand, deal. That's how the flying elephant and that happened, because that karanga sauce.
Wow, that's amazing. Wow.
Yeah.
So that's why you're here today at Flying Elephant?
Yeah, the karanga sauce make in a restaurant. And we will make all over around the world.
Yeah.
Concept. We will go everywhere with karanga sauce, Flying Elephant, Lord of the Pan, together.
It's going to be big, isn't it?
Yeah, it will be massive.
Yeah.
Couldn't believe it.
Well, thanks for telling us your life story, Nick. It was very interesting. Any last few words?
Yeah, okay. That's anyone you'd like to. If you see my food with karanga sauce, things stuff like that, that belong to me. Nick, really nice. By the way, my name Nick. My last name really nice. My friends say no, it's not.
So karanga sauce is exclusive.
We'll. All over everywhere. You will see in the market, supermarket soon.
Okay.
Yeah, or you can buy online with us, with a Flying Elephant. So you just scan the QR code, mm-hmm. in that menu,
yeah.
Or either on the page, in a Facebook, Instagram, anything to come with that. But you will love it. Karanga sauce can make, can marinate chicken, prawn, and beef, fish, pork, and then you can do a tom yum, you can make tom kha, you can do curry, you can do stir fry, you can do anything.
And then you can use it as a dip as well.
As well, yeah. Yeah, perfect for that. Yeah.
Okay. Thanks a lot then, Nick.
Okay, thank you.